So this is called the novel coronavirus because it is a new virus that our bodies haven't been exposed to, versus we're all kind of used to cold and flu every season. And because it's novel, the information that we know about it is evolving as we're trying to deal with it. So coronavirus is spread through droplets, which means if I cough or if I sneeze, then droplets come out of my nose and mouth and then land on something. And then if you touch it and then touch your eyes, nose, or mouth, then you can potentially introduce an infection into your body. Washing your hands 20 seconds with soap and water is the most effective way to get rid of those droplets. And then the social distancing that we have tried to emphasize keeps you 6 feet apart, so away from those droplets landing on you or from a sick person. Social distancing means it's basically one of many tools we have in public health to try to prevent transmission of disease. So remember that droplet transmission is, we think that if you cough or sneeze, it can go as far as 6 feet. And so if you maintain that 6 foot distance between you and somebody who may be sick, then the droplets won't land on you. Quarantine means you are asymptomatic, not sick. You're just watching yourself for signs of illness. So people coming back from level 3 countries that are told to quarantine just mean stay at home and observe, check your temperature, watch for symptoms like coughing, and see if you develop symptoms. Isolate means that you are symptomatic and potentially infectious. And so what we do in the hospital, for instance, is, you know, the room is only restricted to certain people. People entering the room have to wear certain protective equipment. So isolate really means someone who's sick. Mask is really to prevent the person that is symptomatic or coughing or sneezing from sneezing out or coughing out those droplets onto you. If you are wearing the mask, you're not going to necessarily be protected from things coming to you. So if you're worried about your health, you should always consult with your healthcare provider. And so if you're staff or employee, consulting with your primary doctor. If you are a student and you come to student health and consulting with us, because we can really help, as healthcare providers, help you make that decision based on your health conditions, what the best precautions are for you to take.